Hello everyone. Today we are going to discuss the topic called mathematical model of a system. So up to now we are discussing about what is system, what is control system and the types of feedback. So in this particular lecture we are going to represent how to represent any system in its mathematical form. So first of all, what is mathematical model? What is mathematical model? Mathematical model is nothing but if you represent any system with a set of mathematical equations, then it is known as the mathematical model. So the control systems can be represented with the set of mathematical equations, that is said to be the mathematical model. So why we need to represent any system in the form of mathematical model? Why means these mathematical models are useful for analysis and designing of the system. What is mean by analysis? Analysis is nothing but it is finding the output when we know the input. Analysis of a system is finding the output when we know the input, and the designing of the control system means finding the mathematical model if we know the input and output. So what are the different mathematical models are available? So these are the following mathematical models that are mostly used. Those are differential equation model, transfer function model, state space model. So let us discuss the first two models. Those are nothing but the differential model and the transfer function model in this chapter, and we will discuss about the state space model in fifth chapter of this subject. So let us discuss one by one. So first of all, what is differential equation model? Differential equation model is nothing but the differential equation model is a time domain mathematical model of a control system. That means if you represent any system in time domain, specifically in time domain, then it is said to be the differential equation model. So in order to represent the differential model, equation model, you have to follow some steps. Those are nothing but apply some basic laws to the given control system and get the differential equation in terms of input and output by eliminating the intermediate variables. So in order to understand how to get the differential equation model of a particular system, let us take some example. So this is the simple RLC system. So here we are connecting the RLC elements in series. So we are trying to find out mathematical model of the system. The mathematical model is nothing but we are writing the set of mathematical equations for this particular system. Specifically here we are trying to write the differential equation model of the system. So for any electrical system we know some laws. Those laws are nothing but we know the KCL and the KVL. So here we are having the R and L and C elements. These are connected in the series. So apply KVL in the loop. KVL is nothing but Kirchhoff voltage law in this loop. So if you are applying the Kirchhoff voltage law in this loop, the Kirchhoff voltage law tells that the sum of voltages in a closed loop is equal to the zero. So if you apply KVL here, we are having minus VI, and the voltage across resistor is nothing but I into R plus IR, and voltage across the inductor is nothing but L di by dt plus L di by dt, and voltage across the capacitor is plus V naught. So if you apply KVL in this loop, you are getting minus VI plus IR plus L di by dt plus V naught equal to zero. So that is nothing but so minus VI plus IR plus L di by dt plus V naught equal to zero. So we are taking minus VI to some other side. That's why we are getting the VI equal to RI plus L di by dt plus V naught. But we know that the current passing through the capacitor is nothing but C dv by dt. But here, if you observe this circuit, the voltage across the capacitor is V naught. That's why the current through the capacitor is C dv naught by dt. dv naught by dt. dv naught by dt. So substitute I value. The I value is C dv naught by dt. So substitute this I value in the above equation. So you are getting Vi equal to R into, here I value is C dv naught by dt plus L d by dt. So in place of I, again substitute C dv naught by dt plus V naught. So wherever you are having I, in place of I, just substitute C dv naught by dt. So after the substitution, so here you are having Vi equal to R C dv naught by dt plus L C d square V naught by dt square, because d into dv naught, d square V naught, and dt into dt, dt square, and C is the constant, that's why we are writing here, plus V naught. So this is the equation finally we are getting after substituting the I value. So in order to simplify this equation, just divide this total equation with L and C. So divide this equation with LC. So Vi by LC and RC by LC. So here also we are having LC, RC by LC, and here also by LC. Divide each and every term with LC in order to simplify the equation. And V naught by LC. V naught by LC. Just excuse me for my handwriting. So C and C are gets cancelled. LC and LC are gets cancelled. So what you are getting finally, Vi by LC equal to R by L into dv naught by dt plus d square V naught by dt square plus V naught by LC. So this is the final equation you are getting. D square V naught by dt square plus R by L dv naught by dt plus 1 by LC into V naught equal to 1 by LC into Vi. So this is the representation of the system in the differential equation model. So finally we are representing the RLC system in mathematical model, specifically in differential equation model. So in this way we are going to represent any system in the differential equation model. These models are useful for analysis of the system and the designing of the system. And here we are going for the second model, that is the transfer function model. So in the differential equation model we are representing the system in time domain. In transfer function model we are representing the system in frequency domain, especially in S domain. So the transfer function model is an S domain mathematical model of the control system. So the transfer function of a linear time invariant system is defined as the Laplace transform of output to the Laplace transform of input, assuming the initial conditions to be zero. So this definition is very, very important. The transfer function of a linear time invariant system is defined as the Laplace transform of output to the Laplace transform of input by assuming all the initial conditions to be zero. For example, if you take x of t and y of t are the input and output. So here x of t is the input and y of t is the output. Then the Laplace transform is nothing but x of t is represented with x of s and y of t is represented with y of s. So the transfer function of this system is the ratio of y of s to the x of s. Here y of s is the output and the x of s is the input. So the transfer function is the ratio of y of s to the x of s. So in order to, so this is the transfer function model. So here we are giving the input, that is x of s, and we are getting the output, that is y of s, and the transfer function is y of s by x of s. So here we are representing any LTI system with the block having the transfer function inside it, and this block has the x of s is the input and output is the y of s. So in the previous example we are having the transfer function. So we are getting the differential equation for the RLC circuit. So that differential equation is nothing but d square v naught by dt square plus RL dv naught by dt plus 1 by LC into v naught equal to 1 by LC into vi. So in order to obtain the transfer function model for this system, just you have to apply the Laplace transform on both the sides. So Laplace transform of d square v naught by dt square plus r by l Laplace transform of dv naught by dt plus 1 by LC Laplace transform of v naught equal to 1 by LC Laplace transform of vi. So Laplace transform of t square v naught by dt square equal to the s square into v of s, and Laplace transform of dv naught by dt equal to the s into v naught of s, and Laplace transform of v naught equal to v naught of s, and the Laplace transform of vi equal to vi of s. So after that you are getting the equations like this: s square into v naught of s plus r by l s into v naught of s plus 1 by lc v naught of s equal to 1 by lc vi of s, and take the common term. So finally you are getting s square plus r by l into s plus 1 by lc into v naught of s, that is equal to 1 by lc vi of s. So here v naught s is the output and vi of s is the input. So the ratio of v naught of s by vi of s is the transfer function of the system, that is equal to 1 by lc by s square plus r by l into s plus 1 by lc. So where vi of s is the Laplace transform of input voltage and v naught of s is the Laplace transform of output voltage, and this equation represents the transfer function of the second order electrical system. So this is the transfer function model. So here vi of s is the input, v naught of s is the output, and 1 by lc by s square plus r by l into s plus 1 by lc is the transfer function. So here we show a second order electrical system with the block. This is the block, and this block is having the transfer function inside it, and this block is having input is vi of s and the output is v naught of s. So thank you all. In this video mainly we are discussing how to represent any system in mathematical model. The mathematical model is nothing but we are representing the system in the form of mathematical equations, that is nothing but the mathematical model. We are having the different mathematical models. Those are transfer function model, differential equation model, state space model, and by taking the RLC circuit example we are taking the transfer function model and the differential model of the system. The transfer function model is the very important. The definition of the transfer function model is the Laplace transform of the transfer function is nothing but the Laplace transform of the ratio of Laplace transform of output to the Laplace transform of input, assuming all the initial conditions to be zero. So thank you.